All right, so look, the Fed looks for the moment to pull the trigger before year end, but then we got bad news out of China. I want to bring in our traders for the floor show, the New York Stock Exchange, CME, and the NYMEX. John Corpina, this morning, the news out of China was pretty bad. I don't know why anybody is surprised. In essence, China had the biggest export slowdown since February. So their currency is tanking. You would think under those circumstances, they would be able to sell more to countries like us. They're not. Then I start reading that that may hold off the Fed. What do you think the market's thinking? Because we're staging a comeback right now.
I think the market's just as confused as we are. And as that headline that we got out of China, it wasn't overly surprising. It's definitely concerning. And come back domestically, we've got three pretty big things that are going to happen before the end of the year. We're right into earnings season. We're going to get some big financial numbers tomorrow, and we're going to build into that. We've got the election, and we do have the rate hike. We have been talking about this for a long time, when it's going to occur. I'm more in the camp that's going to happen in the beginning of 17, but leaning more towards now that it will happen after this election. I think that's been like the major hurdle of getting past that election to finally do something. But we might get a replay of last year. If you go back to the end of last year, in December we had the rate hike, and the market didn't react positively to it at all. The market sold off significantly January and February. It took us 2.5 months to rebound. I think we might see that again.
Yeah, I mean, a short-term fall. It's totally to be expected, Todd, but the Fed is starting to look like it might be behind the curve. If it doesn't even have the ability to raise one tiny quarter of a percent, I'm less interested in what they're thinking because they keep changing it, and more interested in what an investor is doing right now. You guys see flows of trading on the floor of the CME. What are people buying? What are they selling right now?
Hello, Liz. I mean, right now, they're very edgy right now. There's still some buyers coming in, but obviously they're staying away from the financials for a very good reason, because until rates start to rise, the financials are going to have trouble making more money. Right. So that's one of the big issues that they're having. But we're having, what we're
so
really seeing, Liz, is a lot of
now?
People buying in market.
Look, all of them are down. Why not buy them cheap at this moment?
Now, you know, I like to be a bear a lot of times, but here I would be a buyer of the financials, especially something like a Wells Fargo. I think those are a value play down here, but you're seeing a lot of people buy on margin with money they don't have, but that they can't afford to buy, but they're starting to step in. A lot of the money you're seeing flowing now is retail money, not the wholesale, not the commercial traders. So you're seeing a real push up here at the end, and you saw a little bit of a pullback right down to support today where we should have bounced from. So let's see what happens from here. But I think that the Fed will raise rates, and I think that they'll do it later in the year. But the debt to GDP is a big thing to watch here.
Well, the fact, I have to say, Alan, of part of the reason the market's making a comeback is that oil names started to reverse. They had been down on a much bigger than expected build in inventories for the week. We saw a build of 4.9 million barrels. That means much more supply. Again, the price should be going down. Instead, it's back in the aftermarket above $50 a barrel. We're at $50.49. And yet Goldman Sachs is out there saying, despite possible cuts, the oil market is unlikely to rebalance because the U.S. is still pumping as well, and we're not even part of OPEC.
Well, I do agree. I don't think we're going to rebalance, at least not just yet. I think we do have lower move here. Mm-hmm. But right now, though, it's news-driven, and that news is not making it go either way. So we're range-bound. So for myself, I'm not doing anything until we break 48.50 or, on the upside, 51.77. Overall, though, I think we're going down. I think we got a lot further to go. Yeah. And I also wanted to point out, too, natural gas. It's up at a high right now. It looks like it's going to be a big short, a scaled-in short right now.
Yeah, look, it is up above, it's up 3 and nearly 4% at the moment at $3.33 per unit. Great to see all of you guys. John Corpina, Todd Horwitz.
Thank you, Liz.
Alan Harry, smartest
Thank
in the
you,
business.
Liz.
Anytime, guys. Close